On August 21, 2017, a total solar eclipse took place. It could be seen a narrow path across the United States. Scientists were thrilled. They took measurements and captured images. They hoped to learn a lot. A solar eclipse happens when the moon passes between the sun and the earth. The moon casts its shadow on earth. Sometimes the sun is partly blocked. But on August 21, there was a total solar eclipse. The moon almost fully blocked the sun. Total solar eclipses can be seen from somewhere on Earth about every 18 months. They can draw a lot of attention. The sun all but disappears. An eclipse causes sudden darkness. This lasts for just a short time. Scientists use the phenomenon to learn new things. For example, they can watch how animals and plants react to the sudden darkness. They can also do tests. They want to see how Earth's atmosphere changes during a solar eclipse. Perhaps most importantly, scientists can study the sun. With more information about our own star, scientists will have a better understanding of other stars. Scientists are particularly interested in using eclipse conditions to learn more about the sun's corona. The corona is the outermost layer of the sun's atmosphere. They wanna know why the corona is so hot. It's much hotter than the sun's surface. The sun's surface is about 9.900 degrees Fahrenheit. The corona is several million degrees. During the 2017 solar eclipse, scientists used special solar telescopes. These captured images of the corona. Scientists hoped the images would show nanoflares. These are small bursts of energy in corona. They might explain its temperature. Studying the corona could also help scientists understand solar winds. Solar winds are streams of charged particles. They flow outward from the upper atmosphere of the sun. Solar winds can affect the atmosphere of planets. They don't usually affect Earth. Earth has a magnetic field. It directs most solar winds around the planet. During the 2017 eclipse, scientists used a new instrument. It tracks the temperature and speed of electrons leaving the sun. Scientists hope to learn information that will help them to better understand solar winds. Scientists have learned a lot during total solar eclipses, but there's still plenty they don't know. For a short amount of time, about every 18 months, they have the chance to try to solve mysteries of the universe.
Thanks for watching. Take care yourself.